Hi guys, and welcome to a new video about my favorite simulation, Race Room. Today we have a new track coming to Race Room, famous Daytona International Speedway. This track comes with three different layouts, the sports car track, the motor track, and first time in Race Room we have an oval track. There are still some tracks in Race Room that are normally included in some oval, like the Twin Ring Moktegi or the Lausitz Ring. But actually you're not able to drive these variants. And this will change now. But to be honest, there's actually only the FRUS car that makes sense to be driven on an oval track. So hopefully we'll get some new content in the future. Maybe some NASCARs or some new IndyCars. I personally love oval racing. I love it in iRacing, I loved it in NASCAR 2003. And I hope for some new content and for more tracks of this racing category in Race Room. So now I want to take you on a tour around this new track and give you some details. The track was built in 1957 and was opened in 1959. The sports car course is 6.1 kilometers long, what's round about 2.5 miles. The road car course starts with a left-hander that is pretty long and very difficult to brake, because in the braking zone the track is switching from the banking into the flat infield. Right behind the first corner there is some little chicane that is driven as a straight and leads to the next corner, 180 degrees right-hander. The road car course you see in the background is famous for the Rolex 24 of Daytona that is held every year in January as one of the first endurance races in the year. And it's also the first race of the IMSA season in the USA. After the 180 degrees corner, there's some pretty long straight with a little kink, with a left-hander kink in the middle of it that is driven flat in GTE cars and in LMP cars. Next corner is a long right-hander that leads into a short back straight. The last corner of the infield is a long left-hander that leads into the banking. Pretty important to go as wide as possible out on the curbs to accelerate as early as you can. Now the next part is driven on the oval and in the banking. And as you see in the next shot, with 31 degrees the banking is pretty steep. After the first corner of the oval, you can see a little lake inside the track that was used for speedboat races in the past. The next straight of the oval course is interrupted by a very fast chicane that is driven in third gear with two apexes, and you have to step on the throttle very early to accelerate for the next corner of the oval. With another banking of 31 degrees. And back on the start-finish straight with these amazing grandstands on the right side. These grandstands have an amazing capacity of 135,000 seats. So a little tour around the track is finished with the Daytona logo in front of the start-finish straight, and now I would like to say, let's hit the road. Now I want to show you a lap around the track in the Chevrolet Daytona prototype, a car that was built for this track. So lean back and enjoy the setting sun in this beautiful dusk setting.